Hello everyone, welcome to the demo of Sailpoint Identity Now ticketing integration with ServiceNow. This is Mohit Kayla from ENH iSecure Private Limited. Let's take a look at the demo. This is the partner instance of ENH iSecure for the Identity Now. Now I'm just going to log in as my user Mohit.Kayla. into the IdentityNow tenant. First, we'll take a look at the sources which are present in IdentityNow. For that, we'll click on Admin tab, where we have to strong authenticate. Before we look at the sources, we'll take a look at the virtual appliances and clusters. So in this tenant, we have primary cluster, which is at status warning. We can go into the cluster and open up the virtual appliances tab, where we can see the virtual appliance and its last seen and its status. Now we have a virtual appliance VA 3837 which is connected. Now let's take a look at the sources. Here we have ServiceNow source and VPN access source. First we'll take a look at the ServiceNow source. ServiceNow source has the basic information which is directly connected with ServiceNow, where we have the service account, password and the server host URL. This is directly connected application or the source, where we have 59 accounts in this ServiceNow instance, and we also have some entitlements which are aggregated from ServiceNow. We can go ahead into the ServiceNow instance and check the users. Here we have the users in ServiceNow, which are aggregated into IdentityNow ServiceNow source. So this is a directly connected application where if a new account is requested, depending on the create profile, the account in ServiceNow will be created without any manual intervention or any ticket which is raised through ServiceNow. Now let's take a look at the disconnected application, which is VPN access source. This is a delimited file application or a source which is there for the VPN access for the users or the identities. This has some accounts which are present in the delimited file and entitlements also for the VPN access. We have defined access profile, which is VPN software installation and which has the entitlement of VPN access. This application is been configured with ServiceNow integration through IdentityNow API. The access profile VPN software installation has owner Ali Landre and some of the approvals, source owner and access profile owner approvals, and the entitlements are VPN access. So when a person or a user requests for this access profile contained in a role which is the VPN access request role. Here we can see the role is enabled and requestable, and the role owner is Mohit Kayla, which is me. And we can see that no approval is required. So the approval overrides the access profile. Here we can see under the identity tabs where some of the users who are in this role has this VPN access. Under the access tab, we can see the assigned access profile, which is VPN software installation. Under the membership tab, no membership criteria has been defined since it is not a birthright access for the users. It is an exceptional access which is requested by the manager or the user himself. So this is about the VPN access request role. Now we will try to request for the one of the users and test the integration. For that, I'll just log out of my account and log in as one of the managers for one of the users. Now we are logged in as Nana Kante, and we can go into the request center. Under the roles, we have VPN access request, where we have a description addition to user in the VPN group in AD, and access request on ServiceNow for installation of VPN software. So all the basic information or the description is given here. So I'm just gonna click request, and I'm requesting for one of the Nana Kante's reportees. April Wheeler. We can add comments if we want to. I have added the comment and I'm clicking submit. Now the request has been successfully submitted. We can go to the My Request tab and check the request. Under the workflow, we can see request has been submitted, provisioning is still in pending, and request completed is also in pending. Under the details, we can see on which date it has been created and the role type and comments which we have entered. Now we can go to the ServiceNow and check for the ticket which has been raised. Under the requests, we can see the ticket which has been raised now. Here we have a RITM which is opened by Nana Kante and requested for April Wheeler. I'm just gonna go ahead and approve this ticket. As we can see, we can also see the requested item description, the name, given name, family name, email, location, and manager for the requested person. We'll get into this in more detail in a while. Before we do that, I'm just gonna approve the ticket. Now we can see that the request item 10015 requested for April Wheeler opened by Nana Kante, and the request date is approved. We can see that the status of the request is still in pending. For the integration, for every 15 minutes, the ticket status is checked from IdentityNow. So after 15 minutes, the status will be approved. After 15 minutes, we can see the status approved in VPN access request, and we can see the request completed. Similar to this, we can see other requests which are like incomplete items if the provisioning result is incomplete items, then the ServiceNow will have closed rejected or closed incomplete. For example, this one is having closed incomplete. We can observe that we have request item description as add location, add manager, add email, add given name. So this all information comes from the source. If we go into the VPN access source under the accounts tab, where we can see April Wheeler account has been added, and under create profile we can see the ID, name, given name, family name, email, location, manager, etc. as the identity attribute from the IdentityNow tenant. This helps in the service desk personnel to understand what are all the attributes which are required to create the required account in the specific source or the application. So this ends the demo of the ServiceNow integration with IdentityNow for ticket raising with the access requests or role requests. Thank you.